Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
Yeah! Good morning. Welcome to chapel. Are you excited to be here?
Yeah.
It's our last one. This is our last chapel for our school year. Oh. All right. First, I want to say thank you to our acolytes. Over in the green room, we had Miss Freya and Joshua bring in the light of Jesus. Thank you for your help, acolytes. And over in the purple room, we had Camden. And we had, I can't see him anymore. There he is. We had Jamie. Thank you for bringing in the light of Jesus this morning. We're going to have Pastor Corey come down. He's going to kick off chapel with a prayer and a good morning.
Good morning. It is good to see you. Are you good this morning?
Yeah.
Yeah. You feel good?
Yeah.
Well, you look good. So? All right. Well, are you ready for a great day today?
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, first, I wanted to thank your parents and guardians for allowing you to be with our church here in our preschool. We thank you for entrusting us with your children, and we are just your kids have been amazing this year, especially in this strange year. But we thank you for that, and we hope that y'all have a great summer. But I have one more question. There's something we're supposed to do right now. What is it? What are we supposed to do right now? What am I supposed to do? Pray. All right. Are you ready? Pray. Jesus, we thank you for these children and these teachers and their families. We thank you that you love them, and we pray today that they have lots of fun and joy. In Jesus' name, amen. We'll see y'all later. Bye.
Thank you, Pastor Corey. Well, it's your turn to shine, so boys and girls, stand up right where you are in front of your pew. Miss Jen's on her way to sing This Is the Day.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I love it. You're so awake. Did you drink your coffee this morning?
Maybe a little sugar.
Okay, since you are so vocal today, I want to hear you sing out nice and loud. You know this song super well. I want you to sing it the best you've sung it all year. Let's go. The best you have sung that song this entire year. Good job. You guys were amazing. I know. Look at all this really cool stuff behind us. I wonder what Michelle is going to teach us today. I need you to put one listening ear on. I need you to put the other listening ear on. Eyes up here, bubbles in, and let's see what fun things Michelle has for us.
Good morning. I love how you say it so nice and loud each and every time you're asked that when someone says it to you. You did it for Miss Lori, and you did it for Pastor Corey and Miss Jen, and now you did it for me. So thank you very much. I have a very special guest with me today. Does anybody know who this is?
No.
Does anybody want to guess? No, him. Not yet. Well, he can swim like a fish. It's actually my son, Fletcher. Fletcher is my baby. He's my youngest son, but he's going to be an adult soon. In like 2 weeks, he's turning 18, and I just can't believe it. So he said that he would come and help me teach a lesson for you guys for this chapel. Do you guys remember what you've been learning with Miss Jen at Bible time? What have you been learning about? Oh, yeah, I know, in music, you get to sing that song. How about obeying? Have you been talking about obeying in Bible? Yeah, so God tells us that it's really important for us to obey our parents, our moms, and our dads. But it's also important for us to obey our teachers and all the other adults in our lives that are there to help us, right? Yes, I didn't hear a very loud yes. Yes, it's important to obey. So, Fletcher is very good at listening to me and obeying. And the reason he is so good at it is because I have a trick. Does anybody know what this is? It is a spray bottle. Do you think there's anything in it? There is. There's a little something in it. There's water in it. And when my kids were little, I would spray them when they did something wrong. So I thought I would show you the trick. All right. So now he knows how to listen. Now, this is, do you see my circle? You might, guys might not see it, but there's a big hula hoop here. And they hold it up so they can see it. See it? It's a circle. So we're going to put it down. This, I have this here because it is a way for you to see a safe zone, right? So this is our circle of blessing. And when we obey God and our parents, we're in this circle of blessing. And that means that we're protected. It keeps us safe. If we step outside of the circle, sometimes we can be in danger or be doing things that are bad for us. That's why we need to obey. So we have some examples here of things that we would not do on a normal basis. And I'm sure as I talk about them, Fletcher's going to stay inside that circle that he's supposed to be inside of and obey me, right? Yes, he's going to do that because he's a good listener. So one thing up here that's actually really dangerous is this. It's a candle, but you know what's inside the candle?
Fire.
Yeah. No, it's real fire. Are you guys allowed to touch fire?
No.
No, because what could happen if you played with fire? You could get burned and you could be hurt. So you have to listen and obey and not play with fire. Yes? Oh, right. You could get hurt. What? Look. Behind. I'm supposed to look behind me? Fletcher! What are you doing? Was that obeying? No! He didn't listen. That's disobeying, and that's bad. He steps outside the circle. Fletcher, come on. You're trying to be an example for these kids. Okay, another one would be if we went up to a dog that we didn't know and we started petting the dog. Should we do that? No. That's exactly right. We need to ask the owner. Why do we, and our parents too, right? Why would we ask, what? Fletcher, put down the dog. What are you doing? Oh my gosh, he's making me look bad. I told him you were a good listener. But the dog could bite you, right? And so you wouldn't be safe. Or you could scare the dog. Of course not. But he might bite someone else. Yeah. He did. All right, so we're going to get back on track. I'm so sorry if you guys were ever bitten by a dog or any other animal. But we have to be really careful around animals because sometimes they're scared of us, right? So we have to protect them. All right, so what else do we have up here? Oh, I know. Do you see I brought Cece up. Did you see Cece?
Yeah.
And because I thought we could pretend like this pool was the ocean and set Cece free. Would that be good? Maybe. But then we'd miss him, right? So I'll put him back. But I thought we could use that as an example. And right now, his belly is really full. So I'm just going to leave him right there. He's got lots of money in there that you guys brought in for chapel change. All right, so if you're at the beach, do you go swimming without your moms and dads?
No!
No! You should always be with an adult because it could be dangerous. How many of you have a pool in your backyard? Raise your hand if you have a pool. Do you go in that pool without your mom and dads? No. Because then you're stepping outside that circle of blessing. What? Fletcher. Fletcher. What could happen if he went in there by himself? He could drown, right? And so we don't want to do that. If he stays right inside that circle of blessing, Fletcher, then he's safe and protected, right? How about eating? How many of you ate breakfast this morning? And did you eat something super healthy? Good. Do you guys ever... Other than Easter morning, do you guys ever eat candy for breakfast?
No!
Because that's not healthy. It won't make your brain work right, right? So you have to obey your parents. And if they say don't eat candy for breakfast, oh, Fletcher! Oh, and he got the nerds, my favorite. Fletcher! Oh, I don't even know why I brought him with me today. Don't even know. All right, how about this? How many of you throw stuff in your house? Do you throw balls or frisbees in your house?
No.
No. What would happen if you started throwing something in your house? That's right. You could break something like glass. So we don't throw things. I am so disappointed. You could have hit a light or a kid or a camera. That's it. We'll get it at the end. I don't think my water bottle is working very well. Do you? No. Ugh. Fletcher, what happened today? Just couldn't help yourself, huh?
Are you sorry?
He is. It is bad to disobey. So, Fletcher, are you sorry for disobeying me today?
I'm sorry.
You're sorry? I forgive you.
Ah.
I forgive him. You know what? Our moms and dads always forgive us when we make a mistake, don't they? And so does God. Sometimes we're going to make a mistake and we're not going to obey our parents. That's not good. But if we say we're sorry and we tell our parents what happened, they'll forgive us. Right? And that's very important. But we do have to remember that obeying is important to God. So important that he put it in the Bible, in the commandments, that we're supposed to obey our moms and our dads. Do you guys think you can do that for me? Yes. Okay. All right. Will you pray with me one last time? Ready? Pray. Dear God, thank you for creating a circle of blessing to keep us safe. Help us to always obey. In your name we pray, amen. Awesome. You guys have been so amazing this year. I'm sad that some of you are leaving, but I hope you'll come back and visit. And you can always watch us on YouTube because we have our children's chats on there. And let's give Fletcher a round of applause for coming. Because really, Fletcher is very good, and he was just playing today so that you guys could understand what we were talking about. So we'll see you guys around campus.
Right. Can you say thank you, Miss Shelley? That was a perfect lesson, especially going into summer. Good things for us to remember. Everybody stand up. We are going to do some extra shining today. We're going to end the year with two songs. Now, this one we've been working really hard on. Is it good or bad to disobey? Bad. So we are going to do our song, It Doesn't Pay to Disobey.
It doesn't pay to disobey. Jesus said, listen to your folks and do the things they say. 'Cause kids who break the rules should never get their way. It doesn't pay to disobey. It doesn't.
That was very good. Now, it's the end of the school year, and you're moving up to the next grade level. You're getting big. So what song should we sing?
Bigger.
Say it again.
Bigger.
All right, I want to hear you sing it.
I don't have to grow enough. I'm big enough.
there anything you want to say, Miss Lori? You were amazing today. Have a wonderful rest of your day, and I'll see you later. Bye.